His father is the GM of the Minnesota Vikings. His uncle was an All-American at Ohio State. And he was originally committed to the Buckeyes for a completely different sport compared to football. Not only did he make the right decision choosing the game of football, but he became a star. He was one of the top freshmen in the country, was an All-Big Ten selection, and many believed he would be an NFL draft pick in just a couple of years. In today's video, we're going to talk about a former blue chip recruit whose time in college football has sadly come to an end. It was announced today that he has decided to retire from football, so I thought it'd be a great opportunity to take a look back at his career, everything that has happened, and what kind of went wrong for him. Today's video is supposed to be very positive though, as he was a great player in college, and I'm really excited to do this video. I'm also joined by my friend Jonathan from Embrace the Grind, so be sure to check out his channel, subscribe to my channel, hit that like button, and let me know another player I could take a look at next. Now, let's get started. So you're probably wondering who the subject of today's video is, and if you are a Nebraska or a TCU fan, then you know the name. It is none other than former wide receiver J.D. Spielman. He spent a couple years with the Huskers and some time at TCU, but he ultimately decided to retire on Tuesday, October 26th. And I'm going to turn it over to Jonathan as we go back in time and see how he rose to begin with.
Thank you so much for having me, Scott. If you have not already, make sure to subscribe to Scott for quality daily college football content. J.D. Spielman was born on December 4th, 1997, and is the son of Minnesota Vikings general manager Rick Spielman. His uncle is former Ohio State All-American and NFL standout wide receiver Chris Spielman, who now works as an NFL analyst for Fox Sports. Spielman grew up in Eden Prairie, Minnesota, and attended Eden Prairie High School, where he quickly became a star on the lacrosse field. As a freshman, JD scored 30 goals and won a state championship playing lacrosse. He would actually score the game-winning goal in the state championship game that year. That July, he would commit to play lacrosse at Ohio State. Looked like he was going to be joining his brother Ronnie on the Buckeyes roster in 2016. Then he decided to do something some might consider crazy, throw his collegiate lacrosse career out the window to pursue football. Spielman spoke on the decision to Bleacher Report saying, "I just love football and can't get enough of it. I realize that I can't imagine being done with the sport after high school, so I'm doing everything I can to reach the next level." He approached his father after his sophomore year and talked to him about the change in sport he wanted to make. Spielman told Bleacher Report, "He was honest with me, saying if you're serious about making it to the next level, you need to get bigger, faster, and stronger. Since then, we focused on my nutrition and training. I've gained about 20 solid pounds by following his advice. Athleticism is important at any level, but size becomes a much bigger factor when you reach college." He was able to drop his 40 time from a 4.6 down to a 4.45. Lacrosse still remained an option for Spielman, but it was going to be his second choice if it came down to playing Division I football or lacrosse. Spielman spoke on the situation saying, "The scholarship is still there, but they understand right now that I'm focused on the football recruiting process. My dad and I had a talk while I was deciding on the lacrosse scholarship. He asked me, if a Division I college football opportunity comes up, would you take it over lacrosse? I already knew the answer. Football comes first." Spielman was a part of Eden Prairie's state championship winning varsity football team that went 12-0 in 2013, but became a key playmaker the following year. He was also a part of another state championship winning lacrosse team that spring. In 2014, Spielman had game-breaking ability which helped his team go 13-0 and win another state title. He was used all over the field as a playmaker. His Nebraska profile writes, "As a senior, Spielman helped coach Mike Grant's Eden Prairie's team to go 11-1 and a trip to the quarterfinals of the Class 6A playoffs. Spielman rushed for 1,259 yards on just 102 carries for an average of better than 12 yards per rush, while scoring 19 rushing touchdowns. He also had 151 receiving yards and 2 touchdown receptions. Spielman had 234 kickoff return yards and also totaled 241 yards on 12 punt returns. Defensively, Spielman had more than 100 tackles and a pair of interceptions returned for touchdowns. His play in 2015 earned Spielman recognition as the Minnesota Gatorade Player of the Year, the Minnesota 6A Player of the Year, and the USA Today Minnesota Offensive Player of the Year. He also earned First Team AP All-State Honors and First Team USA Today Minnesota All-State Accolades as a running back. Throughout his high school career, JD used his father as a resource, telling Bleacher Report, "Having a dad at home who's been around football his entire life is a huge plus. Words can't describe how much he's meant to my improvement as a player. He breaks down my game more from an NFL standpoint than a college or high school standpoint. From fundamentals to film study, it's a big help. All the stuff I focus on using in games now is based on things my father taught me or things I've learned while being on the Vikings sideline." Coming out of high school, according to 24/7 Sports Composite, J.D. Spielman was a 3-star recruit who was the 3rd best player in Minnesota, 28th best athlete, and 509th best player nationally. who received offers from Iowa, Iowa State, Michigan, and Nebraska. Spielman spoke about his recruitment back in 2015, saying, "My whole family has been about Ohio State. My dad asked me if I'd be interested in playing at Michigan. It's a great campus. I visited for lacrosse, and the program is heading in the right direction. My dad told me he was going to talk to Coach Jim Harbaugh and set that up. I'm excited for it. I only bring that up because of his connection to Ohio State because of lacrosse. It didn't take Nebraska head coach Mike Riley long to find JD. Riley told the Journal Star, "JD's uncle showed me a video. He said, 'Hey, I want you to look at my nephew here.' And he got his phone out, and we looked at a few highlights, and that kind of started the process. It basically came down to Michigan and Nebraska because Minnesota came in late to offer JD a scholarship. JD loved Nebraska as a school, and once his mom approved of it on his second visit, Spielman was on his way to Lincoln. Now I will turn it back over to Scott to talk about his collegiate career."
Things looked a little bit different for Nebraska back in 2017 when Spielman arrived. Tanner Lee was the quarterback, Divine Ogzigbo was the running back, and Stanley Morgan was the top receiver on the team. Yeah, it wasn't really close, but Spielman had a great freshman year. Morgan finished with nearly 1,000 yards and 10 touchdowns, and Spielman was still second on the team with 55 catches for 830 yards and 2 touchdowns. The guy was a factor on both the offense and in special teams, and he had a couple of games where he went off. He really turned it on later on in the year, as against number 9 Ohio State, he actually caught 11 passes for 200 yards and a touchdown, and that put his name on the map. He also had 70 yards and 6 catches in a close one over Purdue, 9 catches for 141 yards in a road loss to Minnesota, and 6 catches for 96 yards in a road loss to Penn State. He was a bright young star, and because of that, he was named an All-Big Ten freshman. Well, Mike Riley was fired, and Scott Frost was brought in 2018. True freshman Adrian Martinez was his quarterback, and him and Morgan became the 1-2 punch once again. Against Colorado, he had a touchdown, and he also had a touchdown in their loss to Troy. He once again had a huge game against Purdue, as he caught 10 passes for 135 yards and 2 touchdowns, but it was not enough for them to beat the Boilermakers. He then went for a career-high 9 catches for 209 yards and a score against Wisconsin, had a touchdown in an overtime loss to Northwestern, and 8 catches for 77 yards and a score against Minnesota. At this point, Nebraska was not going to make a bowl game, but he would still finish the year strong. He had nearly 100 yards in a loss to Ohio State, had 7 catches for 71 yards in a game against Illinois, and also had over 70 yards receiving against Bethune-Cookman. Spielman had another great year, and he was closing in on some Nebraska records if he would keep going at this pace. He finished with 66 catches for 818 yards and 8 touchdowns, and he was going to be the guy in 2019. The only other competition on the roster was Wandale Robinson, and Spielman had a great year. He had 5 catches for 112 yards and a touchdown in their overtime loss to Colorado, had 160 yards receiving in a win over Illinois, and somehow, like always, had 6 catches for 123 yards in a road loss to Purdue. Nebraska was once again not going to make a bowl unless they finished the year strong. Spielman had 7 catches for over 100 yards and 2 touchdowns in a huge win over Maryland. Then in their final game that would get bowl eligibility, Spielman would catch 34 yards and a touchdown against Iowa, but as many of you guys know, the Hawkeyes hit a game-winning field goal, and this would not only end Spielman's season, but also his Nebraska career. He finished top 5 in almost every Nebraska receiving category, and he likely would have gotten drafted had he left for the NFL. At this point, Spielman decided it would be best to leave for a new team, as he decided to put his name into the transfer portal. Honestly, this decision would end up hurting him, as his career would basically fall apart at this point. TCU had just lost Jalen Reagor to the NFL, and it looked like they needed a guy to step up and be wide receiver one. That was obviously going to be Spielman, right? Well, 2020 hit and everything got flipped upside down, and Quentin Johnson and Tay Barber became the two guys. You have to go down the list a little bit, as Spielman was actually 9th on the team in receptions, as he finished the year with 5 catches for 56 yards. This was extremely disappointing, but there was a reason for it. He only appeared in 3 games, as he caught 2 passes against Iowa State, 1 against Texas, and 2 against Kansas State. He ended up going down with a season-ending injury, and this would ultimately be the nail in the coffin for him. Going into 2021, Spielman would have a role, but it was sort of second tier. He caught 2 passes and a touchdown against Duquesne, had a catch against Cal, had 3 catches for 54 yards against SMU, and 2 catches and a touchdown against Texas. He finished the year with 8 catches for 125 yards and 2 touchdowns. And as we found out today, Spielman decided to retire from the game of football. Head coach Gary Patterson would announce that in today's press conference, as he said, quote, JD is going to retire. He's had lingering injuries for 5 or more games, and he said it's just not worth it, and it's what's best for him going forwards. He had a great career at Nebraska and then TCU. He's been a great teammate, and he's been hanging around. He's been motivational, and he's been all of the above. If I was in his situation, I'm not sure I wouldn't do the same thing, to be honest with you. As we take a look at his career once again, he was someone who originally was supposed to play lacrosse and blew up on the recruiting scene and decided to go to Nebraska. In 3 years there, he became a star and was on pace to become the best Nebraska receiver of all time, and he was just 200 yards shy of setting the record. He ended up leaving for TCU, but got hurt after 3 games, and since then, he's been battling injury after injury and decided to retire. His story was great, and I definitely enjoyed watching him, as he was an electric kick and punt returner and was a real threat for Nebraska football back in the day. Sadly, his career is over, but he's just getting started in the game of life, and I'm curious to see what he's going to be up to next. What do you guys think, though? Who is the best Nebraska receiver of all time? What did you think of J.D. Spielman in college? And what is another player or topic I could do next? Be sure to let me know down in the comment section. Smash that like button if you want to support today's video. Subscribe if you're new here. And check out all my other videos on the end screen. And I hope to see you guys again soon. But until next time, peace.